Hunters in the market for a new rifle will have ample choices with the release of plenty of capable firearms this year. As hunters have come to expect, the market has embraced a wide spectrum of shooting styles and budgets. Though it's fair to say the long-range hunting trends and bleed over from competitive shooting competitions have influenced the most recent designs. The truth is, a wide variety of rifle actions and calibers can be effective for hunting whitetails. There are lots of good options for today's hunters, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with sticking to tried-and-true, proven equipment. Yet, choosing the best deer hunting rifle for your next hunting expedition can be a daunting task. There are so many rifle calibers, actions, and various configurations out there that it will make your head spin. To help you on your quest, we've assembled a list of the best hunting rifles on the market today. Whether you're chasing whitetails in a cedar swamp or scouting miles of open prairie for mule deer, whatever rifle you choose to carry in the deer woods this season, hopefully, it will serve you well.
Built for speed. Built for accuracy. Introducing Impulse, the only American-made straight-pull rifle. With 13 patents, Savage amplified innovation, and focused on advanced technology and unmatched safety. At its heart is Hexlock, a robust bolt design with bearings that expand to allow for superior safety. As gas pressure from a fired round builds, Hexlock remains engaged. Impulse's multi-position ambidextrous bolt handle allows for multiple positions for the bolt handle angle, in addition to right or left hand position. And with the exclusive Savage technologies you trust, like AccuStock, AccuFit, and AccuTrigger. Impulse, it's the only American-made straight-pull rifle.
Today we're out here taking a look at the brand new Browning X-Bolt Max. A lot of really cool features, especially in the stock. Starting here at the back, you do have an adjustable butt pad. You got three different inserts so you can change length of pull for each individual, even from season to season. If you're changing clothing, going from light clothing to heavy clothing, you want to be able to change that length of pull. Second, moving up, is the adjustable cheek piece. The comb, you can raise it, lower the comb real easy with just a turn of that screw. It is ambidextrous, so you can move that screw to the other side. So left-handers, you didn't get left out. But this is really, this comb feature, adjustable comb, is really cool. Especially as Western hunters, we find ourselves shooting in multiple different shooting positions. I mean, I love to shoot prone, where you can get down on the ground. But a lot of times I find with sage country and stuff, you can't. You're shooting off a pack or you're shooting off a tripod. So being able to move this comb up and down so that you get real consistent cheek weld and proper scope alignment, and your eye is perfectly aligned with the scope every single time, is super critical to repeatability and accuracy. Moving forward here a bit, we've got the vertical pistol grip, which is really nice because you put your hand in a nice comfortable position. You got a nice platform for your thumb here so you not feel like you have to grip the gun in inducing any kind of vibration. And then with the new bolt handle, it's a longer throw, just makes it a little bit easier to manipulate the gun and get into your second round after your first shot. So again, being able to stay in the scope and stay in the gun is what we're really trying to get with this whole configuration. Again, this is an X-Bolt. I mean, an X-Bolt has proven itself as an extremely accurate system. And then you have a total of three different sling studs. You've got one in the rear, two in the front, so you can still mount your sling and a bipod at the same time. So you're not having to take your sling swivels or your sling off and on to put a bipod on. It can stay on the rifle. And at last, you've got a muzzle brake that threads off real easy, and there is a thread protector that you could screw on. So if you're going, if you're at the range, you want to shoot with a muzzle brake, but you don't want to use it in the field, you can just screw your thread protector on, you're ready to go.
I'm super excited to introduce the latest innovation from SIG. The first bolt action rifle, the Cross. Let me tell you what makes this rifle special. Starting at the end, we have the taper lock on the stainless steel match grade barrel that allows any SIG suppressor to mate directly to the barrel. However, if you already have a suppressor, we include the taper lock adapter so that any suppressor will screw and mount right on the end of the gun. The barrel is a stainless steel, like I said, match grade barrel that's available in 16 and 24 inch. The calibers that it's available in are 6.5 Creedmoor, 308, and 277 SIG Fury. The forend is a standard M-lock forend that's entirely free-floated. So from the factory, free-floated M-lock. One thing that makes this rifle very special as to the consumer is that you can change your own barrels. So you can remove the barrel with a standard AR-style barrel wrench, and it's a tapered barrel nut that's underneath this handguard. So you undo the nut, pull your barrel out, put your new barrel in, tighten the nut back down. The headspace is set from the factory, so you're able to order a different caliber or a different barrel length or a different taper and just pop it right on the gun. You're good to go. As we move back, let's talk about the trigger and the safety. We have an ambidextrous AR style safety here and an adjustable match grade two-stage trigger. The trigger is adjustable from 2 pounds to 4 pounds. The magazine is a standard AI magazine available from Magpul. They're very common. You can find them pretty much anywhere. The bolt handle is an oversized, easy to lift, easy to operate bolt handle, but it's also interchangeable. So we have multiple different options if this isn't what you want. The Picatinny rail has 4 locking screws on top, and you're able to select which Picatinny rail is right for you. You can have a 20-minute base, you can have a 0-minute base, you can have a full-length base, and all of them will screw right to the gun. So if you want to run anything out in front of the scope, it's very easy for you to do that. If you want to be minimalistic and just have something to mount the optic to, that's available to you as well. Let's talk about the buttstock. We have a fully adjustable comb, adjustable length of pull, adjustable buttstock up and down, and then we also have a QD point for your sling that you can mount on either the right or the left side, whichever you prefer to carry the gun on. It's got a push button, so you're able to push the button and fold the stock, which also holds the bolt handle down, so you don't have any chance that it might disengage as you're walking through the woods.
I'm very excited to introduce the Climber rifle product. It's new for Gunworks to have a purpose-built mountain hunting rig that is still long-range capable. We basically set out to develop the ultimate long-range mountain hunting system. We had some pretty big requirements for performance, shootability, and for size and weight objectives. The Climber is the result of our efforts, and like all of our systems, most of the work that you put into defining what that system is going to do and how it's going to serve the customer is around the rifle stock. That's kind of the platform for the long-range shooting systems. With the Climber rifle system, we've engineered a new rifle stock, and some of the things that we chased here was the size and the weight. We set up the forend just a little bit shorter for compatibility with shorter barrels. The Climber stock features the same negative comb that we have done on all of our rifle stock designs. What that does is it minimizes that recoil moment. Those are some pretty significant design cues. And then on the toe line, we've kept that a little bit flatter so you have some nice bag control and the buttstock doesn't drop as much when you shoot it. A pretty significant design feature that we've built into this is in the grip area. We've built a thumb shelf and kind of a vertical presentation of the hand, so different grips can choke up closer or farther to accommodate different sizes of hands, so it's a very universal, very appropriate grip. That thumb shelf also prevents you from over-gripping and over-torquing that gun. All of our stocks have our built-in integral Picatinny rails. So this bipod just clips in. We take the bipod off, it's flush, so you don't have anything protruding from the stock. Makes it handy on a backpack or shooting bags. I've had the opportunity to hunt with this, and it's very easy to handle. The weight of the package is very nice to handle as well. I'm not against heavy guns, but you know, for some applications, a light gun that's compact is very convenient. We're offering two different constructions. We do a fiberglass construction and a carbon fiber construction. Carbon fiber is a really interesting and unique material. It's very aesthetic, and so most of our paint schemes with carbon fiber will feature the carbon fiber pattern and some paint. In this case, it's black, but we also offer a lot of other colors. Surprisingly, some of the colors that offer orange and other bright colors are very popular. A Climber stock in carbon fiber weighs 1 pound. With hardware, we're about 1.9 pounds, but just the shell itself is a pound. So it's a very light stock. When you go to fiberglass, you add a half pound to that. When you go to the rest of the gun, some of the features that are pretty interesting about this build are carbon fiber barrel, titanium action, and we have our indexing directional brake. My preferred package is a 20-inch carbon barrel with a titanium action with a carbon fiber stock. And that gives me a gun package that approaches the 6-pound mark. As far as like magazine options, we've got a hinged floor plate here. You know, some people in mountain hunting situations don't want the detachable magazine box. They're worried about losing a box, but we do have a detachable magazine box option as well. So overall, this gun has a pretty nice set of options and features. I want to invite you to spend a little time on the Gun Builder, exploring those options, and then really considering what your perfect application is.